Hey everyone, it's Brittany Valadez for BravelyDaily.com. Thank you so much for joining me for this video where I'm going to chat with Kel Mitchell. Yes, Kel Mitchell, you guys loved him on All That when he was younger, as well as, of course, Good Burger. Yes. Well, I had a chance to talk with him about all things Christmas, deliciousness, as well as his career and hold on, you guys. If you didn't know, he is a Christian and a youth pastor. Yeah, seriously, he's a youth pastor. So we're gonna talk about all of that. Now, first things first, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe by just tapping that button right over there. Also, don't forget to hit that notification bell because you'll be notified each time that I upload a new video. And lastly, make sure you follow me on all my social media accounts. It's pretty much just at Brittany Valadez everywhere, but my TikTok, it's a little bit different. So I will put all of that in the description box below. All right, let's get into this interview. Hi, Kel, it's a pleasure to meet you. So we have some mutual friends in this business, as you know, but what we have in common is not Hollywood. It's our faith in Jesus Christ. Okay, how are you a successful Hollywood movie star, but also a youth pastor? Like, how did that happen?
I've got the call to be, a pastor for years, you know what I mean? But I was just like, you know, navigating through life, you know, and the mistakes that we make along the way. And I was doing everything with my own understanding, right? And it was getting me hitting a wall and hitting emotional walls and obstacles. And then when I just said, you know what, I'm gonna surrender all to God, and that's what I'm gonna do. And I'm gonna put him in everything that I'm in, you know, including my family, my career, everything. And that's when doors started to open up for me, meaning like insight, purpose, why I'm here, you know what I mean? And then the things that I went through in life, I could now have a testimony to help others. And so knowing that, when it was like, okay, I heard it in the prayer time, because I in the morning and I heard it so clearly, God was like, I want you to preach now. And I also want you to stay during entertainment as well. And I was just like, okay. But what's been awesome about it is that it's been a blessing. At first, I was like, how is this gonna work? But it's working beautifully. It's definitely working and it's been great. Now I go on set with the mentality of like, you know, who can I meet with? Who can I pray with? You know what I mean? As I go there, and it's not like I'm just grabbing people like, come here, pray with me. But it's just like, you go in there transparent. Where it's like people see the God in you. And it's not about me. It's not about Kel. It's about, you know, you meet people for a reason. You meet them and you can give them that joy and show them the joy of the Lord that you have within that moment. And me and Allie talked about that a lot on set of Dancing with the Stars. You know what I mean? I was like, when we were about to go out and dance, and she was saying, oh man, I'm nervous. And I was just like, see God in the audience. See him there. He's there with us, right? And she's like, right, yeah, bro. We're like, yeah, let's go. Yeah.
All right, so you're executive producing the new version of All That. And of course, fans may or may not know, I mean, plenty of us know, that you starred in the original version and it pretty much made you a household name, and then followed that up with Good Burger. And you're also starring on Deliciousness. You've got so many things going on. Obviously, your career is hot. Fill us in.
Well, yeah, Deliciousness, super excited about that. We're so excited about the premiere because, you know, ever since we shot it, we're just like, oh, I can't wait for this to come out. And everybody on social media has been hitting me up. They're super excited about the show. And it just shows you the power of ridiculousness in Rob's mind. You know, we worked together on Wild Grinders back in the day. So, yeah, just super excited about this. So I'm excited. And then, of course, All That is just doing amazing. To be producing that show on the show that I got started on, it was so surreal in that moment. And I remember when I got to meet the kids in person, because I saw their auditions, but I got to meet them in person for the first time. And the Lord told me, he said, right before you go into the room and when you meet them, I want you to tell them something that you would have wished somebody told you. And what was super awesome about that is that I got in front of them and I said, remember that you were made great when you were knitted in the womb. God made you great. So this show is not the thing that's gonna make you great, all right? So don't lean on your character of what you're playing, you know what I mean? Just know that you were great before it started. This is just one part of your journey, one part. This is a job, and there's gonna be a whole full journey you're gonna go on, and you're not your character. You know that you were great when you were born. And so just saying that gave them the perspective as they're going into it, because as child stars, you kind of mix it all together. And so if it stops, it slows down, then your mindset goes, well, wait, what happened to that producer? I thought that was my friend. What happened to this? And then, and it's like they really can't really navigate. And it's like, oh, it's a job. And that's the hard part, to like figure that out at that moment. So it's kind of like you just, you know, have to realize that. And so it was cool.
The words you gave are correct. Praise God. You were a child star. So, I mean, you might know a thing or two about a thing or two.
Yeah, no, it's been a blessing for me and Keenan to like have experienced it and now give advice to the kids. You know, it's been great. And they're super funny. The kids are doing great on there. Yeah.
Now, as a youth pastor, what are some common concerns that your students have come to you with questions about?
It was a lot about, especially social media. Bullying is another one that happens. Social media bullying as well. Trying to let go of anger and negativity, you know, that's another one. That's why I'm always teaching them to look at there's no failure, there's just lessons. So, and the other thing too about it is that, because a lot of people have been like, a lot of kids have been beating themselves up for things that have happened, and it's just like, you know what, just let it go, let God. And the thing about it is that don't continue, forgive yourself. Because we always, you know, teaching them to forgive others, but also forgive yourself. And also love others, but also love yourself too. And, you know, take time. You don't have to say yes to everything just because that person is cool or this person is this, that, other. And if you feel an inkling like this might not be the right thing, you don't have to say yes to that. You don't. You know what I mean? It's okay to say no. It's okay to take time and pray. It's okay to say, nah, this isn't for me. You know, take it to the Lord first, you know, and then also to find the joy within everything. Find the joy, you know, like sometimes teenagers, we get so upset immediately, like let something just ruin our entire day. You know what I mean? But sometimes you have to go through a storm to see a rainbow. You know what I mean? And as you're going through the storm, know that God is comforting you through it all. He's there. He's there in the time of trouble that we might go through. He's there. Yeah.
So I recently spoke with Amy Thornton's advanced theater class at Burney Middle School here in Texas, and they had a question that I'm going to toss over to you. They want to know, is it possible to be a Christian in Hollywood? Now I have a follow-up question to that. Was there ever a time in your career where, as a Christian, you took a project and you thought, oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that?
First question, totally. You totally can. Totally can. And we need it, you know, and if what's awesome about it is that there's so many Christians that are in Hollywood. You know what I mean? I've been in meetings where big Hollywood meetings and producers all sitting right there and we're all talking and we're talking about the project. And then they're more interested in my faith. They actually are the ones who brought it up. So it's definitely around, and God will send people in your life to work with that are like-minded. You know what I mean? And that has the same, you know, dreams that you have. And, you know, he's using all of his children. You know what I mean? So he's definitely using them in Hollywood as well. So it's nothing that you should be like, no, he'll give you discernment. He'll give you that discernment. And speaking of that discernment with the second question, that's what it's all about. Like every project now, I pray about it. I remember when I first got, started in my faith, when I got started, and I was just going, like, it was roles I was turning down. I left and right. I was just like, nope. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that. And then I got to a point where I started praying. And I remember I asked my pastor, because it was a role that happened. And I was just like, the character's really dark and this all kind of stuff going on. And I don't know if I want to do this. And he was just like, well, what's the message throughout the character? Does it have any growth through it? And I was like, oh. So I looked at that like, oh yeah, it is. Like the character changes around, there's some growth to it. There's something that happens. There's a lesson that's through the character. And so when there's a lesson that's through it, I gravitate towards that, because, you know, yeah, people make mistakes, people do things. And as you play a character, you're telling that story. You're not being yourself, you're telling that story. And if that story can help someone else through it, then yeah, play that character. Yeah, do that film, play it, yeah. But just make sure you take it to God, because that's what I meant, where it's like in everything I do, I take it to him. Yes, I take it to my team and my lawyers and everything, but God first. Yeah.
All right, for your OG fans and your new fans, where can we find you on social media?
You can check me out on Instagram at I am Kel Mitchell. Also, kelmitchell.com, Spirit Food Christian Center, that's my church. And then also Deliciousness, December 14th, Monday. It's a week-long event. We're kicking off the season. It's super fun for the holiday. You're going to enjoy it. Crazy, crazy fun food fails on MTV. Check it out. Yeah.
Kel, I want to thank you for chatting with me. I had so much fun, and I can't tell you how amazing and how joyful I feel when I get to chat with a fellow believer. Loves it. All right, everyone. So if you guys like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I appreciate your subscriptions. Also, what do you think about Kel's story of being a youth pastor / famous actor? Kind of cool, right? I know. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, but please subscribe. Just click right there. Subscribe. Yes. And follow me on social media. It's just at Brittany Valadez, pretty much everywhere, with a few exceptions like TikTok. All right, make sure to check the description box for anything else that I may have wanted to add or just to see where you can follow us. Yeah. Okay, until next time, I'm Brittany Valadez for BravelyDaily.com. God bless, and I'll see you later.